This video is dedicated to Ifeal TV fan, Ayomide Obasa. Ayomide, if you are watching, thank you for lifting the Ifeal TV spirit up. From working at Telnet in 2002 to starting up a company that 18 years later would be worth $1 billion, this is the story of InterSwitch. Before we begin the video, please guys, I'm very sorry we haven't dropped any video for the past 6 months plus now. We have been working on a lot to improve our main company, Ifeal Incorporated. We've managed to develop over 4 apps and 1 game. So I'll drop the link to everything in the description. So thank you. Enjoy the video. Michelle Elegbe graduated from University of Benin with a degree in electrical engineering. On a trip to Scotland, Michelle encountered an ATM for the first time. That encounter with the ATM gave him an idea to enable electronic payments within Nigeria. He returned back to Nigeria and presented the idea to Telnet. They gave him the work at Telnet to work on that idea. But while working on the idea, it didn't really go according to plan. Then Michelle quit his work at Telnet in 2002 and started InterSwitch to execute that idea his own way. InterSwitch started up as a transaction switching company. That's where it got the name Switch from in InterSwitch, but quickly became an integrated payment company. That decade, InterSwitch achieved the following milestones with these various products they launched. They delivered online real-time POS for the first time in Nigeria. With PayDirect, they revolutionized revenue collection from government and large corporations. With their AutoPay, they made online real-time funds disbursement. They also launched a payment gateway called WebPay, which opened up e-commerce revolution in Nigeria. 2009 was a big year for them. That was the year InterSwitch launched Verve. Verve is Africa's most successful card brand that has gone international. A card that is issued by 40 plus banks in Africa and accepted in US, UK and the United Arab Emirates and many others globally. Verve is so big that I would have to later on make a whole video about it. The following year, InterSwitch launched another fire product, a payment app called QuickTeller. QuickTeller was such a big hit that it grew to become Nigeria's number one payment platform. As of 2016, there were over 3 million QuickTeller users. InterSwitch has also been big with acquisitions for scale. In 2011, InterSwitch took 60% stake in Bancom Uganda, and in 2014, they also acquired a majority shareholding in PayNet Group, an East African payments provider, and rebranded them both to InterSwitch East Africa. They did that to reach the East African market. InterSwitch has also sticked their hands into other smaller startups in payments. In 2015, they released $10 million to invest in those startups. InterSwitch is also into entertainment. They have a competition show called InterSwitch Spark. Spark standing for speed, perseverance, accuracy, and knowledge. This is a secondary school-based competition that is designed to support and encourage the study of STEM. Late last year, that is November 2019, for people watching from the distant future. Hi guys. Visa invested $200 million for a 20% stake in InterSwitch, which pushed their valuation to $1 billion. Now, what does the future hold for InterSwitch? With InterSwitch still being on the market for almost 2 decades, InterSwitch is still a privately held company, though plans of going public in Lagos and London has been in talks by the founder, Michelle Elegbe. The current global pandemic and the Nigerian economy might still push that plan a little bit further. I'd also love to see InterSwitch Verve being issued in global banks. But overall, I love the brand. It's one of my best fintech company in Africa. Thank you very much for watching guys. I hope you do like, subscribe and share with your friends. If you have any questions or you have suggestions for the next video, do drop that in the comment section below. Thank you.